Hi Love Bug, Coach Carrie here with another video on the go. So I really wanted to talk about this particular subject. I saw this topic someplace else and just thought I'd touch on the matter in regards to trying to make your partner jealous. Okay. I know we get in relationships and we try to do this, you know, even maybe a couple times just to see what we can get out of it, right? But truth be told, it is like the most asinine and stupidest thing one could do in a relationship. Just one of the most immature acts that a person could do. Here's why that is. Okay, so typically, a person who tries to make their person jealous by trying to, you know, flirt, say whatever, say, just say something, just say whatever it is that's going to take, that they know is going to press a certain button. The reason for that is because there's some attention that is needed. Now, granted, there are different levels of attention. And when someone goes out of their way to purposely, I guess you could say it is kind of almost like hurt the partner by trying to make them jealous, that means there is a certain level of deprivation there. That's one of the reasons. The other reasons as well is to have the person to latch on to you just a little tighter. And so the two types of people who are more prone to trying to make their person jealous is one who is that of a sociopath. You know, a sociopath, they will always try to make it seem like you need to do the most. You need to work harder to keep them. And of course, they know the types of people that this sort of tactic works on. And it's basically to keep that person, you know, begging for whatever it is that they need from them so that they don't go anywhere. Almost kind of like, it's kind of like torture, I would say, or punishing. Or whatever, I'm not sure what the mind frame is of that of a sociopath and their whole reasoning behind it, but more so than likely, it is to keep them in a certain state of mind, a state of fear, that is, to be honest. And it is a tactic that actually works, okay? The other type of person is the one who actually lives their relationship or their life based upon fear. And this individual is more so than likely, I would say, jealous hearted. And because they are or have the tendency to be jealous at times, they try to make their partner equally as jealous because they need some sort of attention. They need reassurance and they're not getting that. So they may flirt or wear something that is going to be a bit revealing, you know, just to send certain signals off to the, you know, to other people, that sort of thing. But does it work? Now, will it work for that in that aspect? More so than likely, it probably won't. And here's why, guys, when we try to make our partner jealous for whatever reason, like I said, it's a very stupid act. It's a stupid tactic to do because, for one, your person is going to think, okay, if you're trying to make me jealous, what else are you trying to do? You know? Now, there's an issue with trust. Can I fully trust you or trust you enough? You know? Then there's possessiveness. When you try to make someone jealous, the one thing that you really don't want to promote or to manifest in your connection is possessive behavior. Because that's what is going to happen. And why is that? Because your person is now fearful that they may be at a state to where they might be losing you, in a sense, right? They may be fearful that they're going to lose you and they may panic And when someone panics, they cling on to you tighter, exactly what it is that you want. But is that healthy though? All right. And then there's jealousy. Oh my gosh. The last thing you need in a relationship is two jealous people. And usually when someone is jealous, they're naturally like jealous hearted on their own. But then to try to make someone jealous hearted, you're creating a monster, because you're going to get problems out of them. Every time you leave, where are you going? What time you coming back? Who are you going to be with? You see what I'm saying? It just, jealousy is going to ultimately and very quickly create other monsters in your relationship. So now we have trust issues, possessive behavior, and jealousy. That's all that's going to really come about your relationship, and all of them are unhealthy. So what are you trying to promote by making your person jealous? By making them jealous hearted because they can't trust you, and because they can't trust you, now they're in fear of losing you. That's all that's conducive to. It's just panic behavior. So here's what, guys, and I know if you are lacking in your connection, some things are amiss, you don't understand your person, if you cannot sit and have meaningful, mature dialogue with your partner about whatever it is, because you're feeling a certain type of way, if you cannot do that, that really speaks volumes about your relationship. You know that, right? It also signifies if you have to do that, if you have to go to that extent. I mean, one time I can understand. Like I said, we've all probably done it intentionally or unintentionally. But to do it multiple times to try to get your person's attention, that means you are trying to probably keep someone who does not want to be kept. Again, that speaks volumes if you're going out of your way to do the most to try to keep someone. So at the end, it's going to just end up in a game of run or chase. You're chasing a person in a relationship who doesn't want to be kept. And there's a reason for that, which is why, again, you need to sit down and have meaningful, mature conversation about whatever the conversation is, because there's no way that you're going out of your way because you're jealous hearted or you have issues with jealousy and trust to try to make your person the same way. That's crazy. That's insane. You do not want to do that. I promise you. You do not want to have two people in a relationship who are now both having struggles with trust and jealousy issues. Now, where is that going to take you? I'll let you answer that on your own. All right, my loves, I just thought I'd share that bit of information with you. I mean, the only thing that you can do about that is find out where your person's mind and where their heart is and where it wants to be. And then, hey, you know, if it doesn't sound like it's going to work out, well, then that's on you. All right. All right, my loves, I thank you so much for joining me always. Until next time.